Hey, this is Carlos Rafael Rivera. I'm super excited to get to share with you a little bit about the show Hacks and the music behind it. Actually, what I really wanted to do was talk about two character themes. The first one being what was written for the amazing Jean Smart's character, Deborah Vance, and the second one for Ava, played by the fantastic Hannah Einbinder. Now, one of them, Jean Smart, plays a character who's on the twilight of her career and on her way out, and while Ava's character is on her way up. Now, they are very seemingly opposite. So in my initial conversations with the showrunners, Lucia Agnello, Paul Downs, and Jen Statsky, I started to try to get a sense of who the characters were, and the first thing I came up with was what would be Deborah Vance's theme, which was something that went kind of like da-da-da, 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 ba-da-da, 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 something like that. But anyways, it was something that had grit to it. And I actually sang it to them on the phone, and they seemed to like it, which was, crazy. But then the idea was to kind of make it more musical through the keyboard. So one of the things that really struck me was that opening scene from episode one, from season one, which establishes our lead character, although very wealthy, she's very lonely. And that kind of loneliness in that big space I wanted to portray through a piano, an analog sounding instrument of her time. And they really seemed to like that, and so I was super, super happy because they did, and it kind of worked. But then we actually get to really see Ava and her environment in the beginning of episode two, as she's sort of now moved in to start assisting Deborah, and she's in Las Vegas staying at the Palmetto Hotel in a dingy room kind of thing. And what's amazing is that I was able to write something that they approved. And what I wanted to do was represent her more with like an electronic instrument, like a keyboard as opposed to a piano, kind of do a slight contrast, and also have more of an up kind of music, up-tempo music. And this is Ava's theme that we hear at the beginning of episode two. So that's Ava's theme, and as you can tell, it has more pep, and it's got movement, and but the one thing I wanted to do, and this is kind of like more of the nerdy music stuff, I wanted to kind of represent Ava's music as ascending or going up, because she's coming up in her career, right? So here's the accompaniment. This is what the accompaniment's doing in the theme. Can hear it going up, right? Now the contrast would be what's happening with Deborah's theme on the piano, more of the analog instrument instead of the keyboard, but this is what we can hear. Her career is fading, it's therefore going down. Right, you can hear it, obviously. Now, that was one of the cool little things I kind of was, you know, interested in. I never really discussed this with the producers, but as long as they were approving the cues, I was happily moving forward. One other thing I wanted to kind of let you know, though, even though they're very contrasting characters, is that they do seem to be reflections of each other. Kind of like ultimately what I think makes a story really work is the fact that they're really mirrors to each other, and that's why they seem to do so well together and have such great chemistry and helps move the story forward. So it's just fantastic work made by the showrunners. But what I wanted to do was make sure that they had something in common. So if you can hear the final chords here, just pay attention to the last chord that Deborah Vance's theme has. Here we go. So pay attention to that chord, because you're going to hear Ava's character also have it at the end of her phrase. Right? So this idea is that they both are very much the same. They have something that really connects them. And again, this is sort of like a very personal thing that was motivating me to write. And it's not something I would have necessarily shared with the producers, nor did I. I mean, I could have, but I don't know. Well, maybe they would have cared too. But the point is that it was just helping me write. And that's what mattered at the time. So I want to thank you so much for listening. And I hope you enjoy the upcoming season 2. And happy writing, everybody.